everybody. Welcome back to Engaging the Phenomenon. Today we have a special video which is about UFO Twitter. Now, many people seeing this video may be familiar with UFO Twitter. You may have engaged in UFO Twitter, you may have heard about it, or you may have seen references to it. On the other hand, I'm sure there are many people who are not familiar with UFO Twitter, and probably be a good idea to be familiar with UFO Twitter, either if you just want to observe or participate. So in my opinion, UFO Twitter is fascinating, and in its own right, pretty incredible. You know, it's a diverse group of individuals who are both like-minded and others who are somewhat different, but we're all at the same time, regardless of our own research and opinions, sharing information and engaging in conversations. Some UFO Twitter participants are breaking stories, putting together new information, and then right behind them you have other participants of UFO Twitter that take those stories and leads and follow up and put together more data and information, and we have a pool of information going on through this activity. And UFO Twitter is very fast-paced. It's also very limited in the text you can use, so you have to be fairly concise and to the point in the short limit of text that you can actually use. And believe it or not, that actually works very well for some reason, then in my opinion. So here today, this is somewhat of an unofficial representation of UFO Twitter, because I've asked for this video for the participants of UFO Twitter to speak on their own behalf. So here it is.
Hello, James. I have never been to social network before, but I am very glad to be part of UFO Twitter team. The subject is too exciting, too fascinating, too complex, and I wanted to share this adventure with others, learn from them. People are very friendly here, very fascinated and fascinating, and we have to help all people who work on the subject. It's a kind of political subject, and academic subject, scientific, and everybody is concerned, and it's very important, and it's a great communion to be here all together.
Hello UFO Twitter, greetings from Dublin. Just want to say that I joined Twitter specifically to follow Jeremy Corbell after watching Patient 17, and then it wasn't long before I engaged with all you amazing people. And you know, it's just grown and grown. It's gone worldwide now. We're just all, it's like a think tank. We're all just working together to try and find a way through this maze and find the opening, and we will get there. It's, you know, it's going to take time, but we will get there. With the help of people like Giuliano Marankovic, Joe Morgia, Danny Silva, all the guys that are unidentified, Akam for all his hard work, and of course James engaging the phenomena. So we'll all keep up the work. We'll get there. We will get there. Love to you all.
Hi everyone. My name is Deep Prasad, and I am a UFO Twitter participant. So what does that mean to participate in UFO Twitter? First of all, let's define it. UFO Twitter is the number of people who have engaged with any UFO-related article on Twitter, be it opening a article, replying to somebody, debating someone, thinking about what they read, and so on. So if you've ever done that, you've ever thought even once and you've seen something from UFO Twitter, then you're a part of it. Now, the beautiful thing about UFO Twitter is that it's a group of people who are constantly exchanging ideas and looking for the truth for what people will see as the world's most important secret. Thank you.
My name's Keith Mayo. I'm a founder member of UAP Info and now a member of the Unidentified website. I think UFO Twitter has always been around. I think the hashtag's always been there. Somebody found out the other day on the website. But I think it's gained a lot of traction since 2017 and the emergence of TTSA. It sort of piqued everybody's attention, including myself. I saw the launch, and that's when I started going on UFO Twitter a lot more, making friends. And that's what brought about our website, UAP Info, myself and a few others. So as a creative, that was a really interesting time. Spawned a lot of good things for me. Interviews with some big people like George Knapp, Gary Nolan and Richard Doughty recently, and Nick Pope as well. So it's been really interesting. It's been an exciting time as well. My other reason for UFO Twitter being so good is because it gives me some escape to talk about the thing that I am most passionate about, which is obviously the UAP subject. So I'd say, for me, it's a bit of escapism. It's about community. It's about talking to like-minded people. But most importantly, is highlighting this subject in the public domain. And I think we're doing a really good job of pushing it out there, getting away from the fringe.
I'm UFO Bernie, and if I understand the situation correctly, the UFOs are presumably coming from a long distance and somehow able to get here. Now, don't quote me, but I support disclosure, capital D, for all, and not just the 1%. There are some on UFO Twitter who are pathological liars. You and I know who they are. But overall, whether it's Tic Tacs, Gimbals, Skinwalkers, ATIP, OSAP, Lou, Mr. B, Steve Justice for All, or the Napster, UFO Twitter is the place to be and where you'll find me most of the time. I'm UFO Bernie, and I approve this message.
What's up, this is Danny Silva. UFO Twitter, UFO social media, it's no different than any other social media. It's a toxic wasteland where people think they know what they're talking about. They really don't, and they really have no idea. On the other side, it's a beautiful place where we all get to come together, share ideas, instantaneously share information. All of the generations before us didn't have this chance that we have, so we have to use it to our best ability, and we need to all come together, and we need to get this thing moving. Peace.
Hi, I'm Cosmic Dahlia, aka Joyce. I was asked to do a quick video on my thoughts on UFO Twitter, and here they are. UFO Twitter is a cool place to go to discuss anything weird or strange, from UFOs to aliens to witches, just about anything you can think of.
Hi, I'm Mike. My Twitter handle is Foyaboy. And when I think about what UFO Twitter is to me, I envision it as a vehicle for participation in the topic of the phenomena. And instead of creating barriers for entry into this topic, it removes them, for better or for worse.
Hi, my name is Andreas Freeman Stoll. I would say that UFO Twitter is a representation of the mainstream youth of today coming into ufology since December 2017. Thanks.
Hi guys, UFO Collage here. First jumped on Twitter in the October of 2017 to follow the Tom DeLonge story. Not long after Tom released the startup video for TTSA, the NYT article dropped. It was from the comments section on Twitter that a few of us noticed each other, we followed each other, and as a result of that, websites, blogs were made to further the story. UFO Twitter came about a year and a half later. There's a lot of new people on there now. Just stick to UFO Twitter, because sometimes there's news on there before it's news.
So UFO Twitter is a good thing in the sense where it fosters community, where myself and other researchers and just people are able to kind of openly discuss the topic and make some good friendships along the way. On the other side of that, though, there's obviously a toxicity towards it as well, in terms of the fact where everyone, all the infighting and all the arguing, really adds to this insane amount of ultra skepticism, which in the long run, it just causes more division in the first place. So, those are my thoughts on UFO Twitter.
What is UFO Twitter? UFO Twitter is a response to the status quo, in which the overwhelming vast majority of humans essentially ignore UAP reality, or even worse, they contend that the evidence giving UAP's validity is inadequate. It is an enclave of like-minded people who assess that the layered evidence is so strong that beyond next generation technology is doing incursions into territories all around the world and into restricted military airspace all around the world. Thus, it's worth talking about. It's worth contemplating. It's a place to stay on the top of the pulse of the disclosure process. Now, does some of UFO Twitter have crazy ideas? Perhaps. But there is one unifying thread that unites us all, and that is the assessment that the available evidence out there is compelling enough that at the very minimum, it justifies suspicion that not only are we not alone, and not only are we being engaged by non-human intelligence or intelligences, but governments cover it up. I think that's worth discussing and worth contemplating and worth researching. And that's why UFO Twitter exists.
So there you have it, guys. Welcome to UFO Twitter. Now, this video was very fun to make. It was great to talk to everybody, and it was great to hear from everybody and see everybody in a video format, because we're usually tweeting away and tweet blasting or whatever you want to call it, and we don't see each other on video as often. And I kind of came up with a really cool idea while making this video, which I am announcing now, and I'm kind of gambling on continued participation by UFO Twitter members in a periodic series that I would like to do called Ask UFO Twitter. And I'm hoping to have people drop us some questions with the hashtag UFO Twitter, and what we can do is, in video format, address some of these questions via different participants of UFO Twitter, and do other videos like this, and that would be called Ask UFO Twitter. So I hope everybody enjoyed this. I hope and I encourage everybody to get involved in UFO Twitter. It's probably one of the most fast-paced information bases out there for UFO-related information. Stuff moves so fast on there. All the latest news and breaks are up there in seconds and retweeted and shared out there. That if you really want to keep the pulse on the UAP UFO subject nowadays, it's almost like your best bet to be on the minute to minute is to be on UFO Twitter. So again, thank you everybody so much. I want to thank everybody so much who participated in this video and made this a reality and made this happen. But not only that, but I'd also like to thank everybody for engaging in UFO Twitter and making UFO Twitter reality. You know, I love everybody on there. I mean, I speak to these guys and girls and everybody on UFO Twitter on the day-to-day, you know, throughout the day sometimes on all these different topics. And it's, you know, it's really been a solid for me to have a great group of people like this where we can come together and work on one subject with passion and honesty. So thank you guys so much, and I hope to see a lot more of you guys. Take care.